Indiana.
Okay, it's going down.
Oh my God.
What'd you say? What did you say?
The reason that I do to tell my story to encourage you, and I dare you to dream. Dreams do come true. You don't realize the power that you have on the inside of you to be and to do whatever you want to be and whatever you want to do.
Better?
I like the, I like both of them. They're both, you know, very informative and being real.
I liked it a lot. Well, I thought they were both great. Like, they kind of connected to each other at the end. Mm-hmm. So that was nice.
I like both because they go hand in hand. You have to be, go the one to be able to connect with the other.
Mm-hmm.
So I enjoy both thoroughly and very well.
Cheese, but without the A.
Mm. promise you could always count on me, darling. From that day on.
You feel good inside.
I'm talking about a fire. And I don't want to think about you.
You said, look at me. You looked at me.
You want
to be in the camera? You want a little camera time? Go ahead, state your name, do a shout out, rep the hood, whatever you want.
About nothing personal.
Yes. Don't bring up any personal business, you know. It's going on YouTube. Yes. Thank you. Taylor.
To be, I forget.
Happy birthday to you. Can we dip? Because I see the promised land. I'm just saying. Show your excitement, Ashley.
Yeah!
Thank you.
and you know that you should say something. It might be back in the gambling halls where you see women mistreated and the sexual trafficking of women. It might be the homeless where you see people sleeping outside with nothing to eat. That's your Edmund Pettus Bridge.
To my hometown of Selma. To President and Mrs. Obama, to all of you, it is indeed a great day to be in Selma, Alabama. Selma is now. Every generation faces its own social and political struggles. There is still much work to be done.
I tell you, it's good to be in Selma one more time. Just one more time. People often ask me, why did you come back? What purpose does it serve? We come to Selma to be renewed. We come to be inspired. We come to be reminded that we must do the work that justice and equality calls us to do. Not to introduce to you, but to present to you the President of the United States. If someone had told me we were crossing this bridge, one day I will be back here introducing the President Barack Obama.
You got it. You got it.
Follow one of your heroes. And John Lewis is one of my heroes. Now, I have to imagine that when a younger John Lewis woke up that morning, 50 years ago, made his way to Brown Chapel, heroics were not on his mind. A day like this was not on his mind. And that's what the young people here today, listening all across the country, must take away from this thing. You are America, unconstrained by habit and convention, unencumbered by what is, because you're ready to seize what ought to be. For everywhere in this country, there are first steps to be taken. There's new ground to cover. There are more bridges to be crossed. And it is you, the young and fearless of heart, the most diverse and educated generation in our history, who the nation is waiting to follow. Because Selma shows us that America's not the project of any one person. Because the single most powerful word in our democracy is the word we. No matter what may be the test, God will take care of you. Yeah. Yeah. Being the only one upon his breast, God will take care of you.
Yes, right about it.
Feel good?
I feel really good. I'm like inspired. I want to cry.
You came out.
Cry almost did.
No.
But, and the party played that led to the Voting Rights Act of 1965 and the presence it has had over the 50 years since. However, Brown Chapel is not a museum. Neither is AME Church as a whole, clutching relics to claim a place in history. We are what we were meant to be from the beginning, a house of worship, a place of study. March 7, 1965 was the first Sunday. the Brown Chapel congregation would have knelt at the chancel rail to receive the blessed sacrament of Holy Communion, remembering that Christ died for the remission of sin. The sacred text reminds us that without the shedding of blood, there is no remission. So it was in Egypt on the first Passover, at Calvary on Good Friday, in Selma on or near the Edmund Pettus Bridge, sin writ in letters large. We offer great thanksgiving to God for the ultimate sacrifice of Jesus and for those who paid for freedom with blood.